Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. I wonder if I started that too fast. Welcome back to Factorio. I still need to get my steel production back up and running, but I just realized there's something that I want to do all the way over here. Yes, all the way. Well, I'm kind of trapped in there. All the way over here. Worker robot is robot speed. Thank you. Okay, let's go back and slow down on the purple science for a while. And actually, let's slow down on the blue science too. I'm going to need rails because of the iron situation. So let's just knock that out real quick. First up, I'm actually going to finally replace these four inserters and finally get rid of these legacy burners, because what I'm actually going to do down here is... where's my blueprints? There it is. I'm going to put... Or, wait, no. I don't have to do anything. Ha! I already did it. These are not in the logistics network. Really? Oh, that's right. They're just outside. But I had walled off the south. That's why. Okay. This is what I get for doing something, running off to do something else, and then you come back and you're like, why did I do this? So yeah, I still definitely want the secondary defenses here. But let's get this in the logistics network. The reason that I finally got rid of these is because I've got solar panels down here. These solar panels should be enough to kickstart the system, even if this gets cut all the way over here. In fact, as a test, that was stupid of me. It's nighttime. Obviously, that's not going to work. Sometime I wonder what I'm thinking. But okay. Well, the idea being is that even if this gets cut, if it's during the day, this will kickstart the system. And I've got water. Water will kickstart the system. I didn't need the burner inserters there anymore. So what I'm going to do now is, since I was thinking about it, I want to make a bunch of requester chests. And what I am going to request is this line here? No. Let's squeeze it in right here. I'm going to require two requester chests. One here. One here. And it's going to seem silly, but this requester chest, I'm going to request... where is it? I'm going to request infinity coal. I always want coal in this chest. And in this chest, I always want wood. I want infinity wood in this chest. And the reason that I'm doing this is one side of this line... This is nice. Research that fast. The top side of this line, obviously, is saturated. So once this fills up... Why are you not grabbing, or have you grabbed already? Yes, you have. Okay. So once this fills up, it will try to put coal over here, and as long as I'm getting coal from up here, that... Wow, look at that. That was impressive, actually. Nice. Okay. So, this will be a way to inject coal into the system from wherever it's stored. At the same time, since I'm no longer using wood for pretty much anything, this will take the wood and put it on the opposite side. So this is now my fuel line that will eventually... Yeah, so you see over here how I'm already getting wood into the system and clearing it out of my logistics inventory. Speaking of logistics inventory, robot. Roboport. Go, go, go. And we'll put that in there. Let's get our light. And yep, even though it's out in the middle of Timbuktu, you never know. Let's get a storage chest here. And we'll put it to the north because, you know, the attack might come from the south, so. Okay. These should be getting their bullets here pretty soon. And there's the wood. That is glorious. So I definitely have the fuel situation taken care of, because almost all of my fuel now, except for this one spur going off into my iron area, all my fuel is going to be routed over to the engines. So I'm good on fuel for quite a long time. Is this actually completely done? Yes, it is. Finally. I want this patch gone. Let's get all of the rails taken care of. Yeah, let's take a look at this and see how this is going. Yeah, see? The logistics network now is keeping up with this. It's not having a problem. Okay, steel. Yes, I'm finally getting the steel taken care of. That's the whole reason that I capped this off, is so I could... Why do I... Really, why do I have this? Was this like a temporary blueprint? I don't need this anymore. Get rid of this. How do we... Darn it. No. I'm going bonkers. I can't remember how to do this. Clue blueprint. Thank you. Okay. Where is my smelting? There it is. So now, if I run to the south, I can fit my steel area right in here. Like so. And now I just need to split a line off. So let's get a fast inserter here. And another just regular splitter here. There we go. Oh, now I understand why I've got these here. Because I need them for extendability. Got it. Okay, so you go to there. No, 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 no. These, no, no. Wrong. Get rid of this. Get rid of this up to there. Okay. This is my output. There we go. Okay, steel is hooked back up with 8 instead of 6 furnaces. So I've actually increased my steel production, which is nice. Okay. And I think, actually, I really did need that steel production up and running. Let's... No. It was... Well, yeah. All the way out to here, so I needed a good amount. Let's get some lights there. Okay. So steel production is sorted once again. I'm capped on oil. I'm capped on heavy oil. Light oil is okay. Capped on petroleum gas, so I'm basically golden here for the time being. How do I want to do this? This is an active provider chest. This is outside the logistics network. I don't need more of this down here. However, I could use a bit more battery production. Yeah, okay. So, chemical plant. Do I have a chemical plant on me? I do not. Let's get rid of these for the time being. Chemical plant. There we go. How many batteries do I have in here? 20? Really? That's all I'm getting? Okay. Okay. So, if I crank the... Let's get rid of this. Let's move it over. Still connects. Good, good, good. And where's our chemical plant? If I put my chemical plant right... If I'm not standing where I want to place it, that would work. That would be nice. Okay. Let's just get the pipe all the way over. And rotate it the proper way. Good. Okay. So what we want to do now is... How do I want to do this? This needs to go away. And get replaced right there. Okay. Let's get our light back down. So I can now extend this. Right, I need the iron over here. That's why that red is there. Okay. More fast inserters. Okay, so you are now making batteries. I need to output the batteries. So now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to pick this up and no, I can't. I can't reverse it. Because I'm foolish. Okay, well, for the time being, what we'll do is... There. Okay. Here. So I'll put batteries there. So now we've doubled our battery production. Except that doesn't work there because it has to go there, which means I can just... Do that. There we go. And now, what I can do is... Aha! I now have a use for these vestigial batteries here. Let's put our passive provider chest back down. Turn it in. There we go. Okay. And once again, let's limit this to the logistics network. Batteries. Batteries, batteries, batteries. There. And let's actually bump it up to 30. If you're less than 30, you may grab batteries. And just for giggles, let's do that. Okay. So now, this will get... One third of the battery split, it looks like. Because one third is going here, one third is going up this way, one third is going down here. So I've effectively increased my battery production for lasers and engines. I could still use more, though. I really could. Rail signals are done. Stack inserter size 3. I think it's 4 where the... No. One of these actually helps normal inserters. 7. Okay, well, I'm not getting there anytime soon. And I'm not using any stack inserters for the time being. Let's... Wait, I've got automation 3 available? Yes, please. Okay. Let's get a bit more battery production. Two more chemical plants. And... How's my sulfur doing? I might actually need a bit more sulfur production as well. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Okay, so... Where are our chemical plants? Let's do it like... This. There we go. This needs to move again. How many times am I going to move this? A lot. And in fact, these need to move down one. That's what I get for not building backwards, right? So where's our... So there's the sulfur input. And what I'll do here... is... screw it up because I didn't build it backwards yet again. Come on. Okay. Yeah, this is 2. Okay, well, okay. So. I was right the first time. What was I thinking? Let's get more power right here. So now I've got more batteries. And I can... snake this around like so. And there's more battery production. Okay. I definitely need more sulfur production. And it is... No, it's... Wait. Why is my... Okay, first off, why... My petroleum gas finally ran out. Interesting. Is this running? Yes, that's running. Ah, but that's the only one that's running because my heavy oil... I bet you my heavy oil is capped. So... And... Is the light oil... Light oil is not capped. So... One more... What's heavy oil is made in a chemical plant? One more chemical plant. About time this happened. I didn't realize that today was going to be the oil episode day. But here it is. Okay. And let's plop this down and see which way it has to go. Heavy oil to light oil cracking. We need the water on the top. Perfect. Okay, let's move it over to... here. Okay. That way I can do... Yeah, I know I'm blocking this off. I'm not worried about that. Okay. So, there's the water input. Here is the heavy oil input. And then the light oil input, or output, will be right here. And Where's our nearest power? We can hook it up right there. So let's take a look at this. Okay. So now that this is cracking, if we take a look over here, that should be going down and these should be running, which means these are now feeding light petroleum in here, which is now feeding all the way over here. So I don't know if this is not caught up yet. I mean, if this is sustainable, but at least now it's producing. And in fact, this is waiting. And I bet you, is this waiting? Yeah, this still has a little bit of a wait to it. Okay, well, we have a way to get around that. Come on, chemical plant. There we go. There. Okay, so we can go here. And here. Yes, we want that. This gets its own feed there. And this. I'm not worried about running through here at all, so there you go. So now we've got two chemical plants feeding in, we've got one heavy to light, two light into petroleum gas, which means, is this waiting at all for petroleum gas? It's waiting a little bit. So is this. But this is getting its petroleum gas off of... You know what? I'm gonna break this. And what I'm gonna do is make another connection here to there. Okay. The reason I did this is because this was feeding into here first. Now this is feeding back into the storage tanks and then feeding back out from there. And how is this? Yeah, this is definitely working a bit better. Let's just ramp it up. One more. Haven't had any attacks in a while, it feels like. I haven't noticed any attacks, let's put it that way. And, yeah, running up against the wall here, which is fine. Okay, so we need... Looks like there's an attack. Okay. So, the biters are still out there. They still love me. We can squeeze through there still. Good. Okay. This heavy oil cracking... Notice how the light oil is down to 2.2. This heavy oil cracking... Well, no, it should be going up, actually, I think. Because this is supposed to be able to handle, like, 7 of these, I think. So I only need this one heavy cracking plant. In fact, at some point, what I'll want to do is swap these out for liquid pumps and wire this up in such a way that I'm ensured that I always get some heavy... oil over for lubrication, but for the time being, I just want to run through this backlog right now. I don't feel like dealing with that. Let's see how we're doing up here. We've got plastic working fairly decently. So it goes down to 16. Does this... Yeah, this is still waiting a little bit. this is still waiting a little bit as well. What did I say? Let's ramp it up. For the time being, let's get this out of the way, because this is going to have to go right there. And I will need another connection right there. This is going to have to go. But, chemical plant. This actually works. There we go. That's much better. Automation 3 is done. Excellent. Okay, let's get more. I need more logistics slots. That's what I need. Okay. So, we need you up to here. Get out of the way. There we go. You up to here. Okay. So now we have, we went from one to one, two, three, four of them. Look at that glorious backlog of batteries. Oh, that is excellent. We're still waiting here. But this looks like, yeah, there's a little bit of a wait here. But the nice thing is that once the batteries get backlogged, I mean, look at this, we're almost backlogged as it is. In fact, I'm going to change this. If you have less than 30 in the logistics network, how much do we have? We have 66 in the logistics network. Okay, actually, that's fine. So now that I've got this backlog of batteries all the way up to here, the engines will be just producing, the lasers will be producing, everything will be golden up here. The backlog will come into play. And did I ever cap this out? Let's make the cap even bigger. Let's just go to one full row. So what's going to happen is the batteries will backlog. This will start filling up, so I don't really need any more down here. Yeah, if I run to ramp up to full production, but if I do that, then I'll clear out space here, add more things. Like I said, I don't go for massive production right up front. I don't think I've ever said that. Okay, I don't go for massive production right up front. What I do is I go for what works right now. I try to leave space for expansion later on. And I mean, this is working pretty decently. Yes, I was obsessing that this wasn't a straight line. I mean, what can I do, right? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. I think this is the end of the second recording session under the new codec. I still haven't posted any of them yet. I'm only on episode 3 right now. So, hopefully the quality is looking okay. The audio is okay. I'm just cranking these out because I love playing this game. And I'm really happy on where we are right now. Next, I'm probably going to start pushing out of the base now that I've got the base somewhat under control. Anyway, have fun.